Lumberjack, Kenny Crump.
Wow.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm picking that up.
I got it. Yep. There you go. You're the man of the woods.
Yeah, got my lumberjack going on. How you like that? Yeah, urban lumberjack.
Yeah, you are.
Only time I've actually worn this jacket.
You got some man glitter on you.
Exactly, some man glitter. All right, we're hanging out at a piece of Cleveland, a really cool place. Yeah, because it started with Nature's Beauty's Tree Service, and then they started cutting the trees, and like I'm calling it a urban sawmill. But this is, I'm getting a huge education on how this whole lumber thing works. So we watched Fred all morning, you guys slice it. Now you've cut it, you've milled it, so it goes into this is a kiln, one of three you have here, right?
Yeah, this is a vacuum kiln. A vacuum pump takes out most of the air, leaving just enough to push around. And then we heat the air with electricity, and the vacuum lowers the boiling temperature of the water, and we pull it out as steam.
And why do we dry wood?
To stabilize it for when you build something with it, the wood is not moving around.
So now it just makes it really hard, you know, stiff, and you know, you can make furniture out of it or build stuff out of it, but you have to get it to that state. Correct. Now, Mother Nature would take 2.5 to 3 years to get it to that state, but using the kilns you guys have, how does that decrease the time?
3 to 4 weeks for this kiln, 2 weeks for the other one.
Okay, guys, push it in. Yeah, no, you're good, unless they need you. Yeah, so that really helps the process when you guys want to make sure you get wood ready for the customer for whatever they want to do.
Yeah, it's called conditioning the wood.
Wow. That is tremendous. And you said that's a modern day Tetris, just figuring out how you can get the most wood you can inside that kiln.
Yep. Yeah, it's a tough game of Tetris there.
Yeah, gotcha. All right, and they're putting that in there. That is pretty cool. So 3 years of work of Mother Nature done in three weeks. That's pretty amazing. Okay, Seth, come over here. So when all that happens, dun-da-da, here's the finished product. So this is what that looks like when you guys get done, right?
Correct, yes. We got some Amish furniture finishers, and once we hand it over to them, it comes out like this.
So that's solid. And then here's another one over here.
That's popular.
Yeah.
That is Chinese elm.
This is Chinese elm?
Yeah, and this is maple.
And what people might not realize, all these massive trees come from right here in Cleveland.
Right here. Love it.
That is
recycle CLE.
Yeah. Really, you're turning something, you know, that you have to take down because they fall on houses or cars or whatever, and turn it into something beautiful.
Especially with all the storms up in Cleveland Heights. You know, we would love to recycle your tree. Give us a call.
It's funny. And you were born on Sycamore.
Sycamore Street.
Sycamore Street in Cleveland Heights.
Yes.
And over here, look at this big piece. This is a sycamore tree, right?
Yeah, this is sycamore. The next street I grew up on is oak. So it's just funny how my life just played out to tell the story with the trees.
Now look how tall that is. Yeah, that is a big tree.
That's probably about 14, 15 feet.
Wow. And you guys cut it like that. All right, so we're going to take a look at what happens after all this process, but that is a beautiful table, man. That's something else. Right here at a piece of Cleveland, yes, indeed, urban sawmill happening right here. Tons of lumberjacks in this place, but I'm the only one wearing flannel. Go figure.
Right. Yeah.
You look the part. That's all that matters.
You do.
Yeah.
It's good for TV.
Like, well, stupid is Crump. It's 90 degrees in there, and he's wearing flannel. What's wrong with this guy?
I love it, though, over the Kicking It with Kenny shirt. It looks like almost like he's got a Hugh Hefner thing going on.
Yes.
Or a smoking jacket. Yeah.
Kenny, did you see my text from Tim?
Yes, I did. Okay. Yes, I did. Awesome.
I had nothing to do with it.
Neither did I.